My brothers and sisters, when we reflect about this Bible passage, this aspect of the presentation of Jesus in the temple, remember, God, Mother Mary knows Jesus is the Messiah. Joseph knows Jesus is the Messiah. Both of them know it's a miraculous birth, supernatural birth. And both of them know he's the Messiah whom the whole generations waited. In spite of knowing the truth about who Jesus is, they also followed all the rituals of the temple. They also followed the traditions of their faith. They could have easily said, see, the Messiah is here. Why should we follow the rules and regulations of the temple? Because he is greater than temple. Jesus is greater than temple, is greater than tradition, is greater than the law, greater than Moses, and he is with us. Why do we need to follow any other rules and regulations? They could have rejected it. But we know Mother Mary and Joseph followed every written traditions of Judaism. They followed every rituals of the temple. And if you look into the life of Jesus, even Jesus knows who he is. Even Jesus knows who he is. But Jesus made sure to follow all the rules and regulations of the Judaism. Every three times a year, the Jewish people are supposed to visit the temple, Jerusalem. Jesus did it. Every Jewish people are supposed to go to synagogue and pray. Jesus did it. Jesus and the whole family, the all Jewish people are supposed to celebrate the Passover meal every year. Jesus did it. And Jesus and the disciples used to go for prayer in Jerusalem temple very often. Jesus used to do that. And not only that, even after the death and resurrection of Jesus, the disciples continued going to the temple. They continued going to the Jerusalem temple and pray. There was 3 o'clock prayer and morning prayer, evening prayer. They visited the temple to pray until they were asked to leave from the, they were chased out of the temple. When they were chased out of the temple, but still they continued their prayer and breaking of the bread in homes, in the church, in their homes. They come together as community. My dear brothers and sisters, therefore, though Jesus is God himself, he also followed the traditions of human being. He encouraged his disciples to do it. And all the traditions which the church has started, Jesus has started in the early church, and the apostles continued, it should be kept. It should be followed even in the 21st century. Don't ever think that it's a human tradition. Everything is started by Jesus. Everything that is started and continued by the disciples, and it should be continued even today. And that is why the community aspect is very important. When the disciples were together after the resurrection, we know Mary Magdalene was sitting in front of the tomb. Jesus said, why are you here? Go to your brothers. When Thomas was out of the community, Thomas did not have an experience of the resurrected Jesus. But when he came back to the community, and then he had an experience of God. And Jesus also said, all of you together, remain in Jerusalem together as one community, because I'm going to send the Holy Spirit. So that is why every now and then they had a gathering of all the community members in some special places. During the first century and second centuries, they used to come together for breaking of the bread. My dear brothers and sisters, therefore, be a part of your church. Be a part of your community. Don't be isolated. Many people have a tendency not to be attached to any community. They just want to be single and individual families and wandering families, not attached to any of the Christian communities, any of the church community, parishes. That is not a good sign. If you are isolated, it is easy for the devil to attack you. But if you are in the community, all the blessings of the community, you will have a share. All the protection of the community, you will have a share. That is why we have parishes, dioceses, and the whole Holy Catholic Church. We should be part of this community, body of the community. And then it brings you protection. It brings all the blessings that is attached to the community, the church. You also will have a share of it. And all the blessings attached to a small community, it will be you will also get a share of it, because God wants you to have this community. When Thomas was out of community, he did not experience Jesus' power. He did not experience the resurrected Jesus. When Mary Magdalene was out of the community, Jesus came and said, "Go to your brothers and be with them." So this is a clear sign that we should be part of a community, the church which God has given us, and be registered there and be united with them, and also be available for anything that is needed there. And also make sure your children are brought up in the traditions of your fathers, traditions of baptism, sacraments, sacramentals, and all these are very important to be part of this community. Just like Jesus and his parents followed the traditions, we need to follow the traditions which are handed over to us from the time of Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, and continuously until now through the Holy Church.